everyone, it's Lynn from wisconsingarden.com, and we would like to take you on an early July garden tour just so you can see what things look like in July. Do you like my new hairdo?
I think you've been in the garden too long.
Maybe I have. I feel like I have. This was beautiful flowers,
Now
it's going into pods with seeds. So we'll see what those produce.
Look at behind you here. I mean, this is just a cluster.
It's amazing. That's how many flowers there were. It outdid itself this year.
Yeah.
Let me put it that way. Now, if you think that's something, look at this. This is our native compass plant. Some of you may remember when we showed you early this spring and it was just barely knee high. Now it is probably, 12 feet tall?
Oh, no, I'd say maybe close to 8 to 9 feet already.
Now, as impressive as these leaves and stalks on, you would think that there would be bigger flowers. But I guess there's just going to be a lot of flowers.
That's a lot of leaf this year.
These are doing very well. They're very, very happy here. These are the ones that the pioneers used. Very sandpapery feel to it, very soft. And they're oriented usually north and south. You can kind of see that the leaves go north and south. And that's how the pioneers could tell what direction.
And now, look what's behind.
Oh, look what's behind. Rick's favorite mullein going to seed. Or actually flower, not going to seed yet. Yet. Now these are native sunflowers that they don't get huge heads on them like the sunflowers we're used to. They just are prolific. And we started with a tiny little bit. But this is one of Rick's favorite things, that the garden gets lush and filled in. So we still have daisies that sometimes in the garden they go in the spring. These parts are done. These are seeds falling out to seed themselves, and then they rebloom again. This is sedum, regular old sedum. The liatris is coming along nicely. It's going to be very happy. This is queen of the prairie. This is the white one. More liatris. Gee, I wonder how
and
that
your
got
peonies
here.
Were absolutely spectacular
oh,
this year.
Oh, they were.
I mean, they were so heavy. They were on the ground. I have to remember to put a support system around
yes.
there.
Yes, and I have to get over here and take those old heads off. Those tall things are hardy hibiscus. They're the white ones. There's fire grass there on both sides. And sweet peas. Mary Playford. This is what our sweet peas look like in Wisconsin. We just get this color. At least that's all we have ever had. Coreopsis here, ground cover there, a maple tree here. This will be phlox.
The real stuff.
The real stuff. I don't know why this phlox is yellow, or is that milkweed? Not sure. Milkweed likes to come up here. And, of course, the giant fleece plant in its glory. Very happy.
Dwarf considering compared to the other one over there, which is probably close to 10 feet tall.
I think I really chopped on this one last year.
Yeah.
But look at your forsythia that you trimmed after it blossomed, and it is starting all over to bud out again. And of course, this is where I used to have all my liatris and some tulips. This year, we have dill. I can make so many pickles with this dill.
Don't pickle me.
So if I don't cut these heads off soon, I will have dill everywhere. Dill will take over everything.
What do you mean, take over? It's already taken over.
Yeah, but it'll be even worse. So what I will do is I'll chop off the head parts, the flowering parts, and I use the stem part in my garden for squash.
You could start selling it.
I could. I should just say cut your own free. Inside there are my liatris.
They're struggling to find sunlight.
But they are They're just in clumps this year because I just planted them a clump. Wait, Miss Wisteria, you're getting a little out of control here. Back. Okay. Now, Rick also wanted me to plant garlic that we had left over from last year. So this is what garlic looks like if you don't cut the scapes off. This too will be going to seed.
Oh, goody, goody, goody.
Oh, goody. That liatris is going to be so cute. Now, inside there is an allium plant.
How did that get in there?
Well, because I planted it when I planted the garlic. That's a nice little head, compact. It'll make a great decoration when we cut it off and put the wire up the stem and then spray paint it. Great. There was a lot of garlic over here when I planted it, and a thistle that is going to seed. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Be back and get that one. Now, this is a combination, and this is the nemesis of almost all of the United States now. This is a Japanese beetle. They eat over 300 different kinds of plants. There really is nothing that you can do with them.
Look what's coming back. The plant that shouldn't be coming back.
What? You mean morning glories?
Yes. Uh-huh. Oh, goody.
Yep, there they are. And then there's this that we're not quite sure what this was. We planted it. Last year it did very little, and this year it's trying to branch out. So I think that's going to be
leaving.
Well,
it was some type of bush similar to wisteria, if I remember correctly.
Could be.
But I don't remember the name.
And whoa, there it goes.
Yep.
Now, I have pulled a lot of it out of here because it was going everywhere over here, too.
Yeah.
And these are your favorite
I like them. They bring a nice splash of color
in. They are very bright, yes. And then there's liatris that's decided now it's going to do a ground dance. It's kind of like a break dance.
Your liatris is about 3 foot tall.
Mm-hmm. It's great. This is a Baptisia, and this is how it looks for the rest of the summer. Once the flowers are gone, it just stays like a beautiful round bush.
I don't even remember it flowering yet.
Oh, yeah. It did.
Huh. Where was I? Probably working in the office producing your videos,
no,
right?
No, you were busy with the pond. And these are our strawberries that, while they looked like they were going to do really well, I think it was too hot.
Oh my gosh.
And it was cold, and you can see that there's all that wood sorrel in there. I'm just going to have to
I don't want to look
again.
At it.
Don't. You'll be happier if you don't. Okay, now over here, I see more garlic. Do you see it?
Yes. Wonderful.
Mm-hmm. Coreopsis. These are the rest of the
poppies.
Poppies, and I left these seed heads on so when people come to visit and they wonder, you know, what does a poppy look like after it blossoms, that's the seed heads. Now this is an Asiatic lily. I don't remember what color it is. It sort of looks like it's going to be a reddish one, maybe. Earlier in the season, a deer decided to help itself.
We need to put garlic down here.
Thank goodness it's gone now. These are Stelladora lilies. So reliable. If you want something that's reliable, that comes back and is a beautiful color, this is it. These are hardy hibiscus, but these are shorter ones.
Look at those iris back there. I mean, those are humongous leaves.
Yes, they are. They're very happy there.
And the honeysuckle this year was magnificent this spring.
Yep, you see a thistle in there. More hardy hibiscus. This is a reddish one, and this one is that a white one again?
I think that one back here was cranberry crush. Okay. And then this one over here was one of the
white ones,
hardy
yeah.
hibiscus you divided.
Mm-hmm. This is yarrow, but this is a pink one.
You can see how the sun and the heat have just extracted the colors.
Right. Yep.
I mean, even that one over there really struggled.
And do you see that right behind that yarrow?
Yeah.
Do you know what that is? Morning, Glory.
Morning, Glory. Oh, goody.
Uh-huh. Another hibiscus, a shorter one.
And talk about a sacrificial plant. We've talked about this before.
Right. This is called a smart weed, I think it's called.
Yep. And look who's in here.
They really, really like this plant. And it's not a plant that particularly does too much. This is the amount of flower that comes. It's nice in a bouquet, but as long as they want to eat that and not eat my hibiscus, go ahead.
This is looking very hardy. This is almost as tall as you right now.
Yes, it is. This is the biggest it's ever been, I
think.
I love the dark purple leaves.
Mm-hmm. And the blossoms are magnificent as well.
Now, these are more liatris. This is the white one.
These are 4 foot tall. Maybe close, yeah.
And this
over
is
4 foot.
The purple one.
Jeez.
This will be our white one. And look who's on my white one. Go away. And
I'll have to bring the vacuum cleaner out.
Yes, that was such a great idea. That, who told us
Jan.
That?
Jan. Or one of the...
Because it didn't know it was Fee.
Fee.
Wasn't it Fee? She said, fill up your shop vac with a layer of water and soap. Dish soap. Take your shop vac and just vacuum them right off of your plants and they die in the soapy water. Sounds like fun. All right, this is what the Japanese fern leaf peony looks like.
Normally it's greener, but again, it has been so hot. And
yep.
I mean, it's been close to 100 degrees, and we're not the only place, obviously.
Right.
I mean,
we have had some rain periodically, not a whole lot. We're supposed to get some today, we'll see. But we should not complain, because it's just summer.
And I see your clematis is still blooming yet.
Right, one's way up there, and then there's another one behind the hostas, the blue one. And then that vine is a kiwi vine. I'm not sure if I should chop off the top of the vine and encourage it to go into making kiwis.
We'll see.
But that's as big as it ever has been. Another very reliable plant is the yellow yarrow. Just be sure when you're buying it that it's not one that'll take over. The first yarrows that were available just kind of went everywhere. These stay where they belong, and they're beautiful, and they last a long, long time with their flowers.
Well, I can see I have to get out here and cut the grass tomorrow.
Yes, yes, especially if we have some rain.
This is the first day it's been cool.
It is.
I mean, it's still, what, low 80s maybe? 70, high 70s?
Maybe high 70s. It's still kind of muggy, but compared to how it has been, this is workable weather. So it's been nice.
Well, this is the first day of this week you were actually out working in the garden today.
I was. Usually the only thing I could ever do is just water, and then I turned out wetter than the plants I was watering because it was just so hot and muggy. Today I actually could do some work. Our container plants are doing very well. I have a lot of zinnias, and you can see that the Japanese beetle have been on that one. This one, I don't know. I've planted several things in here. These look to me, and they are marigolds. I also have some nasturtiums. What I originally planted in here was cosmos. These are the ones the squirrels were digging in. Those never came up. So
look at your weeping tree.
That tree is amazing. That one also is doing very well. It's as big as it's ever been.
And that was after trimming it.
Yeah. I think I'm going to have to get under there and just chop an ending there.
Give it a haircut.
Yes, Jingle, we hear you. We've mentioned before that the tricolor beech really like water, and especially in the weather we've had. So several times we have watered this tree for lengths of time. And if we hadn't, it would look much worse than this. It's amazing how sensitive it is.
Well, I'm glad to see most of it has kept its color.
Yes, and the very ends are starting to rejuvenate themselves, which is good.
I mean, when you really look at it, in the morning, it will truly be blazing.
Yes.
But after this heat, oh boy.
Yeah.
What a difference.
Well, we'll just have to make sure we keep watering. Another tree that needs extra water in times like this is the birch tree. Birches also like water. And in spring, we weren't so sure on how this one was doing, but it seems to be doing much better than we thought it was.
Yep.
And that's good. Now, if you look over here, you don't see a whole lot right now because most of it has flowered, or like the phlox there. I trimmed that down so that it'll bloom later and be fuller. And you can see some of the new growth from where I trimmed it.
Mm-hmm.
This is the Wagelia, that's rebloomer, and we've trimmed this one back as well. But a lot of things are just kind of done for now, and waiting for the next thing. Now there is a canna that we planted coming up. We got them in late, but they're showing up, so that's good. So we did have a couple of dahlias that we put into pots, and that one over there was one of the only ones that made it through the winter, so we planted that. And then this is bugbane. It's coming up and doing its thing.
Oh, look what's starting to blossom.
And that is another version of Queen of the Prairie. This is the pink one.
That is absolutely beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a pink cloud. Mm.
I remember as a child that there was like one kind of hosta that everybody had. Now there are so many different kinds of hostas, and some of them just outdo themselves when they blossom. Just look at that. That one tiny, this is like a mini leaf, and it's just crazy full of flowers.
Well, we were visiting that gentleman a few miles west of us who had over 400 different varieties.
Yes.
That was interesting.
Just all different colors, all different size leaves, different flowers. Some are very fragrant. And
even miniatures.
Yes. So if you have shade, hostas are not boring anymore. And here's our 5-in-1 apple tree. And we just wanted you to see that this year, yes, we are going to get apples. This is the Granny Smith branch, which seems to be the most prolific branch on this particular tree this year. And then this one over here, this is whatever that says down there. Can't reach that part yet.
I have to straighten this tree.
We're going to have to straighten it, and we have to get rid of this.
Our blackberries are invading. I mean, look at the prolific blackberries you have here.
They're just cascading down.
I mean, every place. Well, that's going to be wonderful. They're even inside that cage. And then, of course.
And then there's the raspberries. Now, the sparrows have been in this patch for weeks. I was afraid there wouldn't be any left for people consumption, but it seems like there will be. I would say within the next day or so.
I think there's enough to start picking now, and then probably for the rest, maybe the next week or two.
Or three, or four, or five, or six, or seven, eight, nine. Now the peach trees have gone crazy as well. They are just having a great time. Didn't get any peach blossoms this year because of the frost, I'm guessing. Once winter comes, we will do a lot of trimming just to make sure we maintain the proper shape we need and the branching that we need. But they are very happy. But look what's behind them.
Put your hand next to this blossom.
This is elderberry. And it smells very nice. It has a very fruity perfume to it. We've never ever had elderberries. We've had this plant for probably 5-6 years.
So what's happening here? Somebody nibbling?
Either that or they haven't blossomed yet. Yes. So what are these little things? Never saw those before.
Hello.
Or maybe something's eating them. Who knows? Yeah.
And look at what's growing here. This is the first time we've had blueberries off of this plant.
Yes.
And there's one that's really developing nicely right there. I'm going to pick that one.
Go ahead. You can eat it because there's another one.
Give it a try. Prost.
Full of flavor.
That is very delicious. Nice. Wow.
So much different than what you buy in the store.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what this is. Was this our honeyberry?
Yes.
Obviously.
No honeyberries
yet.
Didn't
have any honeyberries.
Maybe next year.
Yep.
More blueberries.
More blueberries. When you plant blueberries...
And look behind you.
Yes, you have to have a variety of different kinds of blueberries.
There's some in here that need to be picked.
They pollinate each other, but they have to be from different kinds. Now, I know somebody that likes blueberries.
Are you talking about our dog Pepper?
And has been trying to eat them off of the branches. Come here.
Way down there.
Dropping one. There you go.
Beautiful.
Go ahead. Look at this biggie here.
A nice little
beautiful
surprise.
Yes. It's been several years since we've received any grapes. Last year, Rick was determined he was going to trim them back like we always see in movies when you see California grapes or French grapes growing. And that was the trick. They are prolific this year. I think we have 2 or 3 or 4 varieties. I know we have Niagara and we have Concord. Now, when I say somebody likes blueberries, every time I walk past here with Pepper, she's always trying to eat the blueberries. So if we want any blueberries, I just have to keep her away. Well, for once, when they said it was going to rain, it actually is starting to rain. So this is my fenced-in garden. There was several holes that rabbits were getting through, and they ate off my beets, but not my carrots. So we have cucumbers. We have peppers that we've had a couple of. This is a zucchini, and this is yellow squash. We've had some of those.
You have one lying on the ground there.
Yes, I do. Okay. I'll have to go get it.
And then you've got your dwarf tomatoes
These
back
are
here.
Dwarf tomatoes and some radishes.
I'd say they've tripled their size.
Yes. That's a cucumber behind them. These are dwarfs. These are regular size. And they are doing very well. They like this hot weather. And these are tomato berries.
Mm-hmm.
Some of you may wonder what happened to the turkey. Suddenly one morning, she was gone. And something had broken 2 of her 11 eggs. And a couple of days later, when she never came back, they broke every other egg except one that I found today that hadn't been broken. This is the backyard, as you probably know. We've got black-eyed Susans that are coming along. This little rose bush just started blooming in all its scarlet color. This is our bleeding heart, our giant bleeding heart. I've cut it back partway. Coleus. Those are lilies that are done now. But over on this side, you can see that caladiums, that I planted are finally opening. Hee hee! More liatris. Amazing.
Oh, such a surprise.
More black-eyed Susans. Our giant lily is just about done. Smells wonderful.
Elephant ears are doing wonderfully.
Elephant ears are really happy in their containers.
As is the Pleiomy, is that?
Yep, Pleiomy. And this is another hardy hibiscus that's doing well. We kept those alliums there because those, again, are some that we're going to be spray painting eventually. These were also Asian lilies. Those are done now. And here's our pond. We hope you enjoyed this short tour. I'm getting rained on. I'm going to start melting, so we have to stop. If you did, please give us a thumbs up. We'd really appreciate that. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, remember, right over here is that little subscribe button. In the meanwhile, keep the love growing and bye for now. Thanks for watching.
Connect with us on YouTube and subscribe to our channel.